sheep is just as Lord.
We are not talking about sheep, black or white, Sister Mortimer. Of all the candidates for the novitiate, I would say Maria is the least likely.
Children, children. The mistress of Parsons, the mistress of novices, were helping me by trying to express opposite points of view. Tell me, Sister Catherine, what do you think of Maria?
She's a wonderful girl. Well, some of the time.
Sister Agatha?
It's very easy to like Maria, except when it's difficult.
And you, Sister Sophia?
I love her very dearly, but she always seems to be in trouble, doesn't she?
Exactly what I say. She climbs the tree and scrapes her knee. Her dress has gone a tear.
She lost his own face and has a pistol on the stair. And underneath her whip, well, she has curlers in her hair.
I'm even her
for she's always late for chapel,
but her penitence is here.
She's always late for everything,
except for every meal.
I hate to have to say,
Maria's not an answer to the honor.
I'd like to say a word on her behalf.
Insist, Margaret.
Maria makes me laugh.
How do you solve a problem like Maria? How do you catch a cloud and pin it down?
How do you find a word that leads Maria?
That's the hardest rule of all for me. Sister Margareta is always reminding me, but too late.
after I've already started singing.
And the day you were singing in the garden at the top of your voice.
But Mother, it's that kind of song.
I came to the window and when you saw me, you stopped.
Yes, that's been on my mind ever since it happened.
It's been on my mind too, Maria. I wish you hadn't stopped. I used to sing that song when I was a child.
Singing it always makes me feel better. Where did you learn that song?
I was brought up in these mountains myself. Maria, in spite of what you saw of the Abbey wall, you were not prepared for the way we live here, were you?
No, but I pray and I try.
Tell me, Maria, what is the most important lesson you've learned here?
To find out what is the will of God and to do it.
Even if it is hard to accept?
Even then.
Maria, the dress you wore when you came to us, is it still in the robing room?
Why, no, Mother. I'm sure it's been given to the poor. Sister Margareta says that when we enter the Abbey, all of our worldly clothes are... Why do you ask?
Maria, it seems to be the will of God that you leave us.
Leave? Oh, please, Reverend Mother, don't make me leave.
For a while only, Maria.
But this is my life. This is what I want.
But are you prepared for it? Perhaps if you go out into the world for a time, knowing what we expect of you, you will return knowing what to expect of yourself.
I know what to expect, Reverend Mother, and I'll do it, I promise.
Maria.
Yes, Reverend Mother. If it is God's will, where am I to go?
There is a family. A family with 7 children. You like children, you're very good with them. They need a governess until September.
Until September?
Captain Von Trapp expects you this afternoon. He's a fine man and a brave one. He was given the Maria Theresa Medal by the Emperor. It's for heavens in the Adriatic.
Captain in the Navy? Oh, Mother, he'll be very strict.
You're not being sent into battleship, Maria.
Whenever God closes the door, somewhere he opens the window.
What will this day be like? I wonder. What will my future be? I wonder. It could be so exciting to be out in the world.
Sometimes she doesn't hear, sir.
I'm sorry, sir. I was answering the telephone. Good day, sir. We're happy to have you home again.
Where did the last governess leave?
Who knows? She just said I've had enough of this. And walked out.
Why? Is Louisa playing tricks on her again? Putting toads in her bed?
She didn't complain of that, sir.
Well, there's another one coming today, and this one can't walk out.
Oh?
She's coming from Nonberg Abbey with orders to stay until September.
I hope you'll be at home for a time, sir.
Just until tomorrow? The telephone call, was it for me?
No, sir. It was for Franz. But before you arrived, there was a call from Vienna, Frau Schrader. I have the number in the pantry.
I know the number. Oh, I shall be back in about a month with some guests.
Yes, sir. Do you know how many, sir?
Just two. Herr Detweiler?
Herr Detweiler.
And Frau Schrader.
Who wanted me on the telephone?
It was the post office. They've got a telegram for you. It'll be delivered at 7 o'clock.
7 o'clock? That gives me 5 hours to be nervous.
Would that scatterbrain boy delivering telegrams?
Well, that's one thing people are saying. If the Germans did take over Russia, we'd have efficiency.
Don't let the captain hear you say that. He didn't whistle for us when his wife was alive.
Well, he's been the captain of a ship again.
I can't bear being whistled for. It's humiliating.
In the Imperial Navy, the bosun always piped for us.
But I wasn't in the Imperial Navy.
Too bad you could have made a fortune.
Thank you. come only when they hear their signals. Now, what I want you, this is what you will hear.
You won't have to bother, sir, because I can never answer to a whistle.
That's nonsense. Everyone in this house answers to a whistle. I'll show you.
Yes, sir.
It is my executive officer, my orderly, my butler, Fräulein Maria.
Yes, sir.
My executive officer, Frau Schmidt, the housekeeper. Fräulein Maria, please make sure her room is ready.
Yes, sir.
I shall now leave you with the children. You are in command.
Pardon me, sir. I don't know how to address you.
You will call me Captain.
Thank you, Captain. I forgot to return this whistle, Captain. And won't be needing it, Captain. Well, now that there's just us, would you mind telling me your names again and how old you are? Now you're...
Liesl, I'm 16 years old and I don't need a governess.
Thanks for telling me, Liesl. We'll just be friends.
I'm Friedrich. I'm 14. I'm a boy.
Boy? Oh, you're almost a man.
I'm Brigitte.
You didn't tell me how old you are, Louisa.
I'm Brigitte. She's Louisa. She's 13 years old, and you're smart. I'm 9, and I think your dress is the ugliest one I've ever seen.
Brigitte, you mustn't say a thing like that.
Why not? Don't you think it's ugly?
If I did think so, I wouldn't say so. I'm Kurt. I'm 11. Almost.
That's a nice age to be. 11. Almost.
I'm Marcia, and I'm going to be 7 on Tuesday, and I like pink parasol.
Pink is my favorite color, too. And you're Gretel. And you're how old? 5? I'm going to tell you something. I've never been a governess before. How should I start?
You mean you don't know anything about being a governess?
No.
Well, the first thing to do is tell Father to mind his own business.
No, Louisa, don't.
What's in here?
That's my guitar.
What did you bring this for?
For when we all sing together.
We don't sing.
Of course you sing. Everybody sings. Now, what kinds of songs do you know?
We don't know any songs.
Not any?
No.
No.
Well, now I know where to start. I'm going to teach you how to sing.
Let's start at the very beginning. A very
goodnight, Rolf.
Liesel.
Yes?
You don't have to say goodnight this early just because your father's home.
How did you know my father was home?
Oh, I have a way of knowing things.
You're wonderful.
Oh, no, I'm not, really.
Yes, you are. I mean, how did you know 2 days ago that you would be here at just this time tonight with a telegram to deliver for Franz?
Well, every year on this date, his sister always sends him a birthday telegram.
See, you are wonderful.
Then can I come again tomorrow night?
Rolf, you can't be sure you're going to have a telegram to deliver tomorrow night.
Well, I can come here by mistake with a telegram from Colonel Schneider. He's here for millennia staying with the gallbladder, but... Oh, Lisa, no one's supposed to know that. Don't tell your father.
Why not?
Well, your father's pretty Austrian.
We're all Austrian.
Yes, but some people think we ought to be German, and they're pretty mad at those who don't think so. And they're getting ready to... Well, let's just hope your father doesn't get into any trouble.
Oh, don't worry about father. He was decorated for bravery.
Oh, I know. I don't worry about him. The only one I worry about is his daughter.
Me? Why?
How old are you, Liesel?
16. What's wrong with that?
You wait, little girl, on an empty stage for fate to turn the light on. Your life, little girl, is an empty page that men will want to write on.
To write on.
You are 16, going on 17, baby, it's time to be. Better beware, be canny and careful, baby, you're on the brink. You are 16, going on 17, fellows will fall in line. Eager young lads and roommates and cats will offer you food and wine. Totally unprepared are you to face a world of men. Timid and shy and scared are you of things beyond your ken. You need someone older and wiser telling you what to do. I am 17, moving on 18. I'll take care of you.
Thank you.
of him. Even before it's made, it's the prettiest dress I've ever had. I hope the captain will like it, because I plan to ask him for some more material.
More?
Oh, not for me. For the children. For play clothes.
The Von Trapp children never play. The captain doesn't like them to get dirty.
But they're children. They have to play. They have to climb trees and roll in the grass. Think of all the rocks and the
captain says the best exercise is marching. The children will continue to march. I hope you find your room comfortable.
It's very nice, thank you.
There'll be new curtains for the windows. They'll be hung tomorrow.
But these curtains are fine.
There will be new curtains.
Will the captain be away long?
I don't know. Of course he has to come home every time he has a new governess. So, I sometimes think the children get rid of their governesses just because they want to see their father.
He must want to see them too.
Since his wife died, they remind him too much of her. You can put that away. You won't be using it.
Why not?
The captain won't have music here.
He won't have music?
And he used to love music. There were wonderful evenings here. His wife would sing, and he would play the violin and the guitar. But now he shut that all out of his life.
So that's why he is the way he is. But still, not to have music. That's wrong for the captain, and it's wrong for the children, too.
It will work out. He may marry again before the summer is over.
That would change everything. The children would have a new mother.
It's going to rain. You'd better close your window.
Dear God, I know now that you've sent me here on a mission. I must help these children learn to love their new mother, and to help them earn her love so that she will never want them to leave her. I pray that this will become a happy family in thy sight. God bless the captain, and God bless Liesel and Friedrich, Louisa, Brigitte, Marta, and little Gretel. And, oh yes, I've forgotten the other boy. What's his name? Well, God bless what's his name. God bless the Reverend Mother and Sister Margareta, and everyone at Nonberg Abbey. And now, dear God, about Liesel. Help her to know that I am her friend, and help her to tell me what she's been up to.
You're not going to tell me, are you?
Help me to be understanding so that I might guide her footsteps. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen.
I was taking a walk outside, and somebody locked the doors earlier than usual. I didn't want to wake anybody, so when I saw your window open... Oh, you're not going to tell Father, are you?
Did you climb up that trellis to get up here?
That's how we always used to get in this room to play tricks on the governess. Louisa can climb it with a toad in her hand.
Liesel, were you out walking all by yourself? You know, if we washed that dress out tonight, nobody would ever notice it tomorrow. Then all this would be just between you and me. You could put this on. Go take that in there, put it to soak in the bathtub, and then come back out here and have it.
I told you today I didn't need a governess. Well, maybe I do.
Anytime I feel bad, I just try to think of nice things.
What kind of things?
Well, afraid of the storm and the sword. Yes, Captain.
And do you? Or do you not have difficulty remembering such simple instructions?
Only during thunderstorms.
Liesel?
Yes, Father?
I don't recall seeing you anywhere after dinner.
Well, as a matter of fact, you see, I was...
Yes?
Well, I was...
What she's trying to say, Captain, is that Liesel and I have become better acquainted tonight. But it's much too late to go into all of that now. You heard your father, children. Back to bed immediately.
Fräulein, you have managed to remember that I'm leaving in the morning? Is it also possible you remember the first rule in this house is discipline? And I trust that before I return, you will have acquired some.
Captain, I was wondering if before you go, I could talk to you about some clothes for the children.
Fräulein Maria.
For when they play. If I could just have some material.
There are obviously many things, not the least of which is repetitious.
But they're children.
Yes, and I'm their father. Good night. Because you liked me.
Well, of course I liked you. Why shouldn't I like you? You live like a king.
You have an excellent wine cellar.
Max!
I like rich people. I like the way they live. I like the way I live when I'm with them. Speaking as a government official, Georg, is there a cathedral around here?
That's our abbey, Nonnberg Abbey.
And do they have a choir?
A beautiful one.
Good. In the next few days, I must visit all the towns around here and listen to singer rooms, choirs, quartets.
You'll be here for meals, won't you?
Oh, yes. It was in a town just about that size. Walsworth, where I discovered the St. Ignatius Boys Choir. In 1930, they won the festival, became quite famous, toured all over the world.
Oh, yes. Whatever became of them?
By the time their voices changed, they were rich enough to live in America. Who lives in that dilapidated castle down there? Rumpelstiltskin.
Baron Elberfell, the oldest family in the valley.
You know, I think I'd like to meet him. I'd like to meet all your friends, Georg. While I'm here, you must throw a dinner for me. Nothing much. Just something lavish.
I wouldn't know whom to invite. Today it's difficult to tell who's a friend and who's an enemy.
Now's not a good time to make enemies. Let's make some friends.
I can't understand what's happened to the children.
You're not worried about them, are you?
They should have been here to welcome you.
Well, it can't have been an intentional slight because they've never met me.
Forgive me, I'll try to find them.
Well, Elsie, have you made up Georg's mind yet? Is he going to marry you?
Oh, yes. He hasn't admitted it yet. There seems to be something standing in his way.
And you don't know what it is?
No.
I do.
What?
It's very simple. It's money.
Money?
Yes. He's rich. And you're rich. In all the famous love affairs of lovers, have to struggle. In garret rooms away upstairs of lovers, starve and snuggle. That famous form is fortune which they seem to have no fear of. While lovers who are very rich, you very seldom hear of.
No little sack does he share with me. We do not flee from a mortgagee. Nary a care in the world have we.
How can love survive?
He's fond of bonds and he owns a lot. I have a plane and a decent yacht.
Plenty of nothing you haven't got.
How can love survive?
Thank you.
not be hyped.
Gail, well, why don't you look at things the way I do? What's going to happen is going to happen. Just make sure it doesn't happen to you.
Max, it's a good thing you have it in character. If you did, I'm convinced I'd hate you.
Oh, you couldn't hate me. I'm too lovable.
And Deb Lemon, there's a call for you. It's from...
I'll take it.
My heart was to sing your sweet song.
After a long and exhausting search, I have finally found a most exciting entry for the Salzburg Folk Festival.
Congratulations, Max. And who will you be exploiting this time?
The Vienna Boy Squire.
Guess again.
The Clockman Choir.
No.
Tell us.
A singing group, all in one family. You'll never guess the order.
Charming idea. Whose family?
Yours.
Oh?
They'll be the talk of the festival. Now what's so funny?
You are Max. Expensive, but very funny.
But you heard them, they'll be a sensation.
No, Max.
It's a wonderful idea. Fresh, original.
Max, my children do not sing in public.
Well, you can't blame me for trying.
Who shall we hear from next? The decision is unanimous, Captain. You.
No.
The children told me that a long time ago you were very good.
That was a very, very, very long time ago.
I remember, Father.
Thank you.
Thank you. You might see whether she would like this.
She'd been dodging these people.
That doesn't mean that she doesn't have a headache. Besides, it's very important that your children like Fundraiser.
I like her all right, but why is it important?
Because I think she's going to be your new mother.
Oh, Fraulein, Father would never marry her.
Why, he couldn't.
Why couldn't he?
Because he's in love with you.
Now, Brigitte, that's just the kind of thing that...
You must know that.
Brigitte knows.
Remember the other night when we were all sitting on the floor singing Nadel Rice? You laughed at him for forgetting the words.
He didn't forget the words. He just stopped singing to look at you.
And when he speaks to you, the way his voice
sounds... Brigitte!
And just now, when you were dancing, you're in love with him.
Maria, you're not going to have dinner with the children tonight. You're going to have dinner down here with us.
But I can't.
Oh, it's all been arranged. You'll have to hurry, though. You'll have to change. Well, Maria, wore the dress you wore the other night when we were all dancing. It was lovely.
Shall I announce dinner, Captain?
No, 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 not yet. The children haven't said goodnight. Georg, I was thinking the children should say goodnight the way they did last.
No, Elsa, not here.
Oh, please, Georg, the way they did it for me. It was so sweet.
Elsa, not in front of strangers.
Please, for me.
Presto, changer.
Max, you're just in time. Come, come, sit down.
Just in time.
Children, now!
There's a sad sort of clanging from the
I waited until she wanted to come to me.
It's strange. She's happy to be here, but she's unhappy too.
Why did they send her back, do you know?
She doesn't speak. She hasn't spoken except in prayer.
I shall see her.
Maria.
This must have been a trying experience for you.
It was, Reverend Mother.
Has it taught you anything?
It's taught me that I never want to leave these balls again.
Why did they send you back to us?
They didn't send me back. I left. I left without telling them where I was going. Without saying goodbye.
Sit down, Maria. Maria, what happened? Why did you do this?
I was frightened.
Frightened?
I was confused. I felt... I never felt that way before. And I knew that here I would be away from home. That here I would be safe.
Maria, our Abbey is not to be used as an escape. What is it you can't face?
I can't face him again.
Thank you, Sister Margaretta. Maria, are you in love with Captain Von Trapp?
I don't know.
Tell me about it, my child.
Brigida said that I was, and that her father was in love with me. And then there we were, and he was looking at me, and I could barely breathe. Then I knew I couldn't stay.
But you do like him, Maria.
Oh, yes, I like him.
Did you let him see how you felt?
If I did, I didn't know that I did. That's what's been torturing me. I was there on God's mission, and to have asked for the captain's love would have been wrong. I don't know if I showed him any affection, but I do know this. I'm ready at this very moment to take my vows.
Maria, the love of a man and a woman is holy too. The first time we talked together, you told me you remembered your mother and father before they died. Do you remember? Were they happy?
Yes, Mother, they were very happy.
Maria, you were born of their happiness, of their love. And my child, you have a great capacity to love. What you must find out is, how does God want you to spend your love?
Oh, please don't make me go back, Reverend Mother. Let me stay.
Maria, you must go back. You must find the life you were born to live.
Thank you.
Right, copper kettle.
sure?
Yes, he just told us.
We found him! We found him!
Hazel.
Louisa, Paquita, boys. Marie will be in the nursery.
You came back?
Yes.
You left without telling anyone where you were going.
It was very wrong of me. Please forgive me.
You're back to stay.
Only until arrangements can be made for another governess.
Oh no, you've been missed by the children. I've missed. Everyone's missed you so much since you've been gone. Nothing was the same. Everything was wrong.
But I can't.
Go on up to the children now, Marie. We'll talk about it later. Maria! A new dress?
We have a new postulant.
I know I'm right. Max will find him and ask him.
I'll take your word for it, Elsa.
Georg, settle this matter for Max and me. Just how far down the mountain does your property go?
You make out that stone wall down there. That's the property line.
You see?
I didn't argue.
I know, and that makes me furious. I don't like to win without fights.
Adela, while you were gone, you had a long distance call from Berlin.
Now, who could be calling me from Berlin?
They said you'd know.
Oh. Thank you, Franz.
Max, this isn't the first call you've had from Berlin.
Georg, you know I have no political convictions. Can I help it if some people have?
Let's not start this whole thing again. Germany's promised not to invade Austria. Max knows that.
Then why does he bother to answer these calls from Berlin?
Because if they don't keep their promise, I want to have some friends among them.
Naturally.
Oh, you agree too?
Georg, this is the way I see it. There was a man who lay dying. They were reading him his last rites. They asked him, do you renounce the devil and all his works? And he said, at this point, I prefer not to make any enemies.
Georg, if Germany were to invade Austria, would you defy them?
Yes.
Do you have any idea what could happen to your property?
To your children.
To everyone who's close to you. To Elsa. To me.
Well, what will you do if they come?
What anyone with any sense would do. Sit tight and wait for it all to blow over.
And you think it will?
Well, one thing's for sure. Nothing you can do will make any difference.
Don't look so serious, darling. Relax. Take the world off your shoulders. You dear, attractive, dewy-eyed idealist. Today you have to learn to be a realist.
You may be bent on doing deeds of daring do, but up against a shark, what can a herring do?
Be wise, compromise.
Compromise and be wise.
Let them think you're on their side, be not committal.
I will not bow my head to the men I despise.
You won't have to bow your head, just stoop a little.
Why not learn to put your faith in your reliance on an obvious and simple fact of science? A crazy planet full of crazy people is somersaulting over the sky. And every time it comes another somersault, another day goes by. There's no way to stop it, no, there's no way to stop it. No, you can't stop it, even if you try. So, no, I'm not going to worry. Every time I see another day go by.
And a cockeyed eagle. We make a cockeyed circle around the sun. And when we circle back to where we started from, another year has run. And there's no way to stop it. No, there's no way to stop it.
If the earth wants to roll around the sun,
you're a fool if you worry.
You're a fool if you worry. Oh, we're ending in
the mental number one.
So every lie.
Yes, and there's no way to stop it. No, there's no way to stop it. And I knew that a man of turning time. That as long as a little, just as long as a little, tell me nothing else as wonderful as
Mother, she told me that you have to look for your life.
Often when you find it,
Salzburg Festival, 1938. And look here. Von Trapp, family singers. And here are all your names. Lisa, Friedrich, Luisa, Marta, Kurt, Brigitte, and Greta.
Why am I always last?
Because you are the youngest.
Now listen, I'm depending on you. Day after tomorrow, you must have everyone ready at 11 o'clock in the morning. That's when the bus leaves.
Can you help me, please? The Gauliner is here. He wants to know why we're not flying the flag.
I
can't explain.
Keep quiet. When is Captain Von Trapp returning?
Who knows? When a man is on his honeymoon.
These are no times for joking. It's been 4 days since the arms troops, and this is the only house in the province that is not flying the flag in the Third Reich.
You need the flag with a black spider on it.
Do you permit such remarks in this house? Who are you?
I am Maximilian Detmar, First Secretary of the Ministry of Education and Culture.
That was in the old regime.
In the old regime, I was Third Secretary. Now, I'm First Secretary.
Good! Then you will order them to fly the flag!
Captain Von Trapp wouldn't... I mean... I only take orders from Captain Von Trapp.
You will take your orders from us! And so will the captain! I am...
Everybody's cross these days.
Is Father going to be in trouble?
He doesn't have to be. The thing to do today is to get along with everyone.
Are you sure Father's going to like this?
He'll be pleased and proud.
Hazel, do you think so?
Ricky, don't you trust me?
No.
Well, anyhow, the bus leaves at 11 o'clock.
Well, at least we'll see what I have here.
That's Father's luggage.
Yes, they're back.
They're back!
They'll have such a lot. Let's not worry about telling him anything.
Max.
Georg, we didn't expect you back until next week.
Max, it's good you're here. There's much I want to know.
Children, we missed you all so much.
What did you miss the most?
We missed all that noise you make in the morning.
The noise you make telling each other to keep quiet. I missed climbing upstairs to say goodnight to you.
We missed hearing you sing.
Then you came back just in time to hear us sing. We're going to see you at the Salzburg Folk Festival.
Max? Are you responsible for this?
I've just been waiting to talk to you about it, Gabriel.
You can't talk your way out of this one, Max.
Presents! Presents! Give me mine!
Presents in the nursery!
Better get out of the country. There are things that happen to a man like that. He better get out quick.
Cry all you want to, but just remember what I said before it's too late. And you remember it too.
Don't cry, Liesl. How could he turn on Father that way?
Maybe he wasn't turning on your father. Maybe he was mourning him. Maybe he was mourning all of us.
Liesl.
What is it, Georg?
Didn't think I'd have to be faced with the decision this soon. Berlin has offered me a commission in their Navy.
Well, Georg?
I can't just brush this aside. I knew it would be exciting for me to have a ship under me again. What I mean is it would be a relief and a comfort to know that you and the children are safe. But it also means, please, Maria, help me.
Georg, whatever your decision is, will be mine.
Thank you. I know now I can't.
Of course not.
I have to get out of Austria.
You'll have to leave, right away, tonight.
Not without my family. I can't just pack up and leave. I have to plan. I have to have time.
Sir, Admiral von Scheiber of the Navy, the Third Reich is here to see you.
Thank you, Franz. You didn't give us time.
We want to make time.
We're going to the children. We must be careful.
What's going on? Stormtroopers, Maria, I was afraid of this.
I need children.
This way, gentlemen. We can talk in here. Admiral von Schreiber, I present Herr Detweiler. Max, I believe you already know Herr Zeller. Would you gentlemen care to sit down?
We are here on business. Captain von Schreiber,
the telegram was sent to you 2 days ago.
Yes, I know, I just received it. I've been away. I've only been home half an hour.
Captain von Trapp has just returned from his honeymoon, sir.
Congratulations, Captain.
Thank you, sir.
Your record in the war is very well remembered by us, Captain.
It's good to hear you say that, sir.
Well, let's get to the point.
If you don't mind. In our Navy, we hold you in very high regard, Captain. That explains why I'm here. With no response to your telegram, the High Command has sent me in person.
I'm very flattered, Admiral, but I've had no time to consider.
I'm here to present you with your commission.
I'm deeply conscious of the honor, sir.
And your orders are to go immediately to the naval base at Bremerhaven.
Immediately? Why, I'm afraid that would be impossible for you, Georg.
Admiral, may I present my wife, Baroness von Trapp. Admiral von Schreiber.
We're all singing in the Salzburg Folk Festival, Friday night. See? Here in the program? The von Trapp family singers.
It's been arranged by the Ministry of Education and Culture. Friday night? This is Wednesday. That's only 2 days. It might be possible. You could report to Bremerhaven on Monday.
Admiral!
Is there a telephone I could use?
Oh, right this way, Admiral. And if there is any doubt, perhaps by adding the weight of my own voice, we can sway them to our side.
It gives here only the names of the children.
Says the von Trapp family singers. And I'm the head of the von Trapp family.
It's hard to believe, Captain von Trapp. You sing in a concert?
Zilla, you may believe what you choose.
It doesn't say what you're going to sing, Captain. What are you going to sing?
It's your privilege to come to the concert tonight and hear us.
Ah, but I want to hear you sing now. Sing for me what you're going to sing in the concert now.
So a deer, a female deer, red and tropical and sun. Be your name, I call myself.
Far along the way to run.
Thank you.
concert that concerns you. Ladies and gentlemen, our festival concert has come to its conclusion. Except, of course, we do not know what that conclusion will be. The judges are putting their heads together as we speak, and while we wait, I think there should be an encore. It seems this may be the last opportunity the Von Trapp family has to sing together for a long, long time. I have just been informed that Captain Von Trapp leaves immediately after the concert to assume his new position in the naval forces of the Third Reich. A guard of honor has arrived to escort him directly from this concert hall to the naval base in Bremerhaven. And now, the family Von Trapp again.
Thank you.
gone.
Reverend Mother, we didn't mean to bring this on you.
Reverend Mother, we can never thank you.
We hid our car deep in the woods. We'll leave as soon as it's safe.
The car will do you no good. They left a guard on the road in front of the gate.
I had been listening to the wireless. All the roads were blocked. The border's been closed.
I used to think of these mountains as my friends, standing there protecting me. Now, they seem more like my enemies.
Never your enemies. Haven't you read? I will lift up mine eyes into the hills from whence cometh my help. You know, I know that mountain as well as I know this garden. And so do you. And once we're over, we'll be in Switzerland.
But the children!
We can help the children.
Father, we can do it without help.
You'll have help.
We shall go out with joy and be led forth with peace. The mountains and hills shall break forth before you into singing.